Part of why we've gotten here today to where we are with a $72 billion debt is inherent in the relationship with the United States. The United States went in 1898. The very next year, Huracán San Ciriaco was the most devastating hurricane of the century. The entire coffee crop was lost, about $50 million worth of coffee. The United States gave no hurricane relief, nothing meaningful. Instead, the following year of 1900, they devalued the Puerto Rican currency by 40%, and they had to hand in all the Puerto Rican pesos which is a Spanish peso, for an American dollar. Now, these are currencies of roughly equivalent value. So they devalued every Puerto Rican. They took away 40% of their net worth. You do that in this country, there's gonna be a revolution. The society could not exist. And then the very next year, in 1901, the Hollander Act created a steeply graduated set of property taxes that had never existed before on the island. So between the hurricane, a currency devaluation, and property taxes, the farmers were losing their property. They were desperate for liquidity. They had nowhere to go. They could only go to one place, the American Colonial Bank. But there was no usury law restriction. So the American Colonial Bank charged whatever it wanted. The reason is they didn't want the debt repaid. They wanted the collateral. They wanted the land. That's what they wanted. And within 30 years, they got it. Here's what happens. By 1930, 80% of the agriculture, of the arable land of Puerto Rico, was owned by North American banking syndicates. They were called centrales. They turned a previously diversified, self-sustaining agriculture into a one-crop cash cow economy, that of sugar. And four of them alone, Fajardo, East Puerto Rico Sugar, Aguirre, and Guanica, those four alone own half of that 80% of the land. So four own half of 80 is 40%. 40% of the acreage of Puerto Rico was owned by four North American corporations. So they divested Puerto Ricans from their own economy. When you add to that now the fact that Puerto Rico is an island with the Jones Act, it's Section 27 of the Merchant Marine Act of 1920, and it is that bill that creates the tariff structure and the pricing structure of all the products that come into Puerto Rico. So between taking away the agriculture from the Puerto Ricans themselves, their own land, and by creating the Jones Act, you basically took away the ability of Puerto Ricans to develop their own economy. They made them utterly dependent on foreign capital and on the United States. And that's the single greatest reason why we are today, because the United States created a completely dependent economy in Puerto Rico.